Something that I think is that really helped us is being able to use and take advantage of your outlets for media. And one of those outlets is obviously the campus newspapers. You would be surprised how much the campus newspapers are starving for material. So you could talk to them about events you're doing, obviously, as has been previously mentioned, but also if there's some remotely related to libertarianism thing going on in the news, especially if it's in your local area for whatever reason, you write them a letter, they'll probably publish it as long as it's not too off the wall. And then you can also name drop the organization. And then a lot of people, I know that around the time that we started up our OUYL, I wrote a letter to the OU Daily, as I mentioned, Young Americans for Liberty, and multiple people came to the meeting who had heard about it because they'd seen it in paper, or they had heard about it from somebody who had seen it in paper. And from that, I also found out that not only are they starving for material, usually they're starving for people to make that material. And it's very surprising how easy it is to get on to your campus's newspaper's staff. Personally got to the opinion staff by just basically going to an opinion meeting and asking if I could. And they allowed me to, and which gave me a platform from which I occasionally can mention OU Young Americans for Liberty or OU Students for a Stable Society, and therefore get it to a greater audience of people who might not otherwise know about not only the organizations, but the ideas themselves. They're generally topics you can talk about once if you do like to write and you get onto the an opinion staff your college's favor, such as when Paul Ryan was selected as Romney's vice president, there was a lot of talk about Ryan Rand's obviously libertarian issue. Which I was able to kind of talk about that and they do some to talk about it. And also you would and also not just the media on your campus specifically, but to also just in participating with the movement at large. Another project I've been a part of is a podcast called Liberty Minded. Our website is libertyminded.org, and basically we just interview people from the Liberty Movement, and there are a lot of people in the Liberty Movement who are very personable and surprisingly nice people who are very, very ready to talk to you despite the fact that you're just some random podcast in Oklahoma, Central Oklahoma. We interviewed, for example, Gary Chartier, who also got us in touch with the then very reclusive Kevin Carson. And then we also interviewed Jeffrey Tucker and Tom Woods just by basically sending these people emails and surprisingly them being very personable and very ready to talk to us. So never underestimate your ability to get in touch with these people to do really cool projects like podcasts or other things you can do, spread information that people might want to, that when people are looking for information on Liberty and they go on YouTube or something, they can have a video to help them find out more about it. And then also the last thing I want to talk about is when you're talking to people on campus, you really want to make sure that you speak with people who are not already libertarians. You want to make sure that you speak to where they already are. You should get a sense of, you should make sure that the conversation is not just you telling them about libertarianism as much as you talking to them about libertarianism. And what I mean by that is people already have their ideas, and if you just kind of spit at them your own ideas, they're always seen as very condescending and off-putting, and they're just going to kind of go on with the day. But if you look as if you're interested, even if you're not interested, but if you look as if you're interested in what they think, they're more likely to be interested in what you think, and you can have more conversation. there are certain topics that might interest them. If they're conservative, but they're not necessarily sure if they're on board with the Republican Party's foreign policy, that's obviously an area you could talk to them about, as we've seen with the last Ron Paul campaign. It's one of the ways you've got a lot of people in the movement. And also, if someone is really interested in issues of poverty, obviously there's a lot of types of ways that government hurts the poor that you can talk to them about. I know that they don't have to not care about these things and still be a libertarian. So basically, that's what I